The James Webb telescope is one of the most complex endeavors humans have ever attempted. It cost NASA about $10 billion to build and consumed countless personnel. Despite multiple delays and cost overruns, the James Webb telescope finally launched on December 25, 2021, making it the most complex and powerful telescope ever made. So, expectations have been high for this brand new time machine in space, and one of these expectations has long been a source of discomfort for scientists. Is there life in other parts of the universe? Is it possible that aliens are waiting to contact us? Icean planets are one of the places where the James Webb Space Telescope may locate aliens or life signals. But how will it do that? How will these discoveries change our understanding of the universe and ourselves? Let's take a look at how the new James Webb Telescope will discover alien life. When James Webb was successfully placed into orbit, scientists had a sigh of relief as they only had one shot at making it successful. The Webb now orbits at the Lagrange 2.1 million miles away from the Earth. When the recently launched James Webb Space Telescope completely becomes online and starts gazing into deep space, it will be more than simply another instrument for astronomers to study the cosmos. Its cutting-edge spectroscopic equipment will allow it to stare out into space and view faraway objects in more detail than ever before, considerably more than its predecessor, the Hubble Space Telescope. It will alter our knowledge of exoplanets, and it may even help us learn about our origins and where else in the cosmos we might be able to live. Scientists will use the telescope to look back billions of years in time in an effort to answer the questions of our origins. However, in between those goals, this powerful telescope will also find the evidence of life in deep space. The James Webb Space Telescope will be used primarily to investigate the atmospheres of exoplanets in order to look for the building blocks of life elsewhere in the cosmos. However, Webb is an infrared telescope. What does this have to do with investigating exoplanets? Using telescopes such as TESS, the Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, and the Kepler Space Telescope, astronomers have discovered planets outside our solar system in recent years. These can look at the brightest stars and detect variations in brightness when a planet passes between them and us, using a process known as the transit method. This is a wonderful accomplishment of scientific observation, but it doesn't tell us much about what those planets are like, only their estimated size and sometimes mass. If we want to know what a planet is like, we need to know if it has an atmosphere. What exactly is it made of? Is there any cloud cover in the sky? Is there any water in there? We need to look at this in much greater depth. That's what Webb intends to achieve, but it will be a major technological task. That's why NASA, the European Space Agency ESA, and the Canadian Space Agency CSA are all collaborating on this project. Webb is 100 times more sensitive than Hubble, and as a result, Webb will be able to expose the most minute features in the furthest reaches of the cosmos with exquisite resolution. Hubble has already helped us to learn more about exoplanets, but James Webb will change the way we observe and study small planets by providing more details about them. Hubble also functions in visible light wavelengths, taking photos in the visible light range. However, James Webb will be operating in the infrared wavelength, which can pick up various characteristics and peek through obscuring dust, offering an entirely new view into the cosmos. Hubble and Webb will be able to work together, gathering complementary data on the same targets. So if you like Hubble's gorgeous views of space, don't worry, they're not going away. We'll merely get another instrument for acquiring a deeper knowledge. The James Webb Space Telescope will seek for signs of life on the Hycean planets. What are Hycean planets and why do scientists believe they may support life? To comprehend Hyceans, you must first understand exoplanets, which are planets that are not in our solar system but revolve around their own sun. Astronomers believe that there are billions of exoplanets in outer space, but they are notoriously difficult to detect because the stars they circle outshine them. To present, around 4,000 exoplanets have been discovered outside of our solar system. Scientists have investigated exoplanets to see whether life may exist there. When determining if an exoplanet can support life, scientists consider whether it is located inside the habitable zone of the stars it orbits. This zone is a sweet spot, which means the planet is close enough to the star for liquid water to have a stable presence on the planet and maybe support life as we know it. However, scientists are currently focusing on a specific type of exoplanet, Hisaeans. Hisaean planets are hot planets with seas and a hydrogen-rich atmosphere that are considerably simpler to detect and study than our planet sisters. We have no Hisaean planets in our solar system. Some of the Hisaean planets are larger and hotter than our planet, but experts believe they contain vast oceans that may sustain the type of life that originated on Earth and can still be found in harsh ocean habitats. One of the most intriguing aspects of these planets is that they have a bigger habitable zone than Earth or Earth-like planets, which means they might still support life even if they reside outside of the zone where our planet is required to be in order to sustain habitability. Researchers have done an outstanding job of detecting and learning about exoplanets with existing technologies, discovering over 4,000 exoplanets so far. However, this discipline is very new, with the first planets discovered beyond our solar system discovered in the 1990s. That implies that many current generation devices, like Hubble, were never intended to study exoplanets. James Webb, on the other hand, was created with the express intention of being utilized for exoplanet characterization in the forefront of its design principles. When Webb is aiming at a star, for example, it will point at a specific pixel with extremely high accuracy and will not move at all, allowing astronomers to very precisely quantify any dips in brightness that may indicate the presence of a planet in orbit. With this degree of accuracy, Webb can perform its most fascinating exoplanet-related function, determining whether or not an exoplanet has an atmosphere and what that atmosphere is made of. Although researchers have devised several ingenious methods for detecting exoplanet atmospheres, present detectors were not meant to do so. That is why Webb's capabilities will be so transformative. Webb contains four sensors that will look into the universe in the infrared wavelength. The near-infrared camera, NIRCam, and the near-infrared spectrograph are two of them, NIRSpec. The fine guidance sensor near-infrared imager and slitless spectrograph, FGS, near-ISS, will look in the near-infrared region, as the names imply. Finally, there's the mid-infrared instrument, MIRI, which examines a wide variety of far-infrared wavelengths. However, this is delicate equipment that require a properly maintained atmosphere to function. As a result, the technology surrounding them must be cutting-edge as well. Webb is brimming with new, complex technology, from the sensitive infrared detectors to the tennis court-size 5-layer Captain Sunshield that will protect the instrumentation from solar radiation and allow the telescope and detectors to reach the cold temperature required for infrared observations. The most fascinating reason to study exoplanet atmospheres is to learn where else in the cosmos life might be able to thrive. The beginnings of life will be one of the primary issues that Webb will investigate. There are many more types of exoworlds than we could have anticipated. There are Jupiter-sized gas planets relatively near to their star, as well as massive rocky super-Earths and warm Neptunes. Some of these may have the appropriate temperature and composition to support life. However, knowing a planet's size and mass isn't enough to establish if it's habitable. For instance, when we discover a planet that is Earth-sized and has a similar mass, we frequently presume it would be a location similar to Earth. However, Venus and Mars are nearly the same size and mass as Earth, and their atmospheres are exceedingly hostile to our sort of life. Mars isn't much better, having an incredibly thin, unbreathable atmosphere that is barely 1% the density of our Earth's atmosphere. So we need to understand atmospheres in order to determine if a planet is livable. Even more crucially, in order to estimate the number of habitable planets out there, we need to know what sorts of atmospheres are normal for planets of our size. We need to know which is the most common type of atmosphere that nature forms. Is it Venus-like or Mars-like? And is Earth an outlier? Or is it possible that Earth-like atmospheres are common and there are a lot of possibly hospitable planets out there? Webb's research will not be limited to exoplanets. It will conduct a wide variety of research, from peering back into the early stages of the cosmos to witness the first galaxies develop, to seeing how stars emerge from whirling dust and gas. We're only scratching the surface of what this new instrument may be used for with its first year of research operation scheduled. We'll have to wait and see what additional celestial wonders it can unearth. James Webb is going to be a game changer. It will enable us to view things that we have been anticipating to see for a long time but have not had the technology to see. So what do you think about the discoveries James Webb will make? Can we find evidence of an alien civilization out there? Let us know what you think in the comment section below. More updates will be coming soon in the next few months and years about the discoveries made by James Webb. So make sure to subscribe to our channel and stay tuned for more intriguing content in astronomy and space science.